Okay, the point of discussion that we'll talk about is Jalodhar. As you all know, Jalodhar is a variant of Udar Rog, and if you see what Charak has mentioned about Udar Rog, in initial phrase he said, Bhagwan Krishna Gatro Atmato Udaro Api, means there is emaciation in the whole of the body and there is distension of the abdomen, which is in classical features of the cirrhosis of liver. If you see cirrhotic faces or the patient who is having cirrhosis, these are the classified features that has been mentioned in the start of the chapter naming Udar Rog in Chikitsa Sthan. So we'll talk about what is Udar Rog and what are the basic things that we have to take care while treating this particular condition. So I will talk about the basics of Udar Rog. As you know, Udar Rog is a disease in which there is a peculiar feature which is called Pratyatma Lakshan. Pratyatma Lakshan means distinctive feature of a disease. And in Udar Rog, the distinctive feature of the Udar Rog is distension of the abdomen, which has been said as Udaro Seth. Means there is, if there is distension of the abdomen, that's only the, that entity will be taken up as Udar Rog. Like other condition like Grahani, Atisar, Pravahika, these are the diseases of Mahasrotas. In there is no distension of the abdomen. Peculiarly, if there is distension of the abdomen, then only you can say that this is an disease which will be labeled as Udar Rog. Now comes the other things. If you see the etiological factors of the disease, how it is going to happen, there are multifactorial things as been mentioned, like dietics. There are certain things which reflects the mechanical obstruction, like antrasammurchan, taking up of, like if you see what bone and hairs and such, and in majority of the situation the worm infestation may also, but these all situations are basically leading to this conditions like intestinal obstruction, intussusception and volvulus, which are obstructive diseases. So in Udar Rog, if you see the various classification of the Udar Rog and various variant of the Udar Rog, the pathology is entirely different. But if I am talking about the basic, all the Nidan has been mentioned, and ultimately it has been quoted that Mandagni Naam Visheshata, means all the Udar Rog are basically attribute because of the Mandagni. And this verse, as the Bhagavat has said, Roga Sarvapi Mandagno Sutra Mudrani Cha. Here Udar Rog or Udar has been categorically mentioned that these are the diseases which are basically because of the Mandagni. And how these are taking place, if you see, whenever we are treating any sort of disease, we must know the samprapti of the disease. The samprapti of the Udar Rog, if you see, Ruddhuva Sved Ambuvahani Dosa Srotansa Sansrita Pran Agni Apana Sandusya Janyanti Udaram Nidam. These are basically two, it is a stroke. In the first line, it is signifying that there is obstruction, there is sang, which is called Srotorod, in which Ambu and Svedva Srotas, and ultimately because of that particular sign, there will be distension of the abdomen. The second line that you see is the manifestation because of the pran, agni and apan. If these are impaired and these are involved, then they can also lay down to the Udar Rog. As you see the classification of the, especially if I am talking about Jalodhar, Swatantra and Paratantra Jalodhar. One, the first line basically, Isneha Pito Mandagno. If you see the specific etiological factor of Jalodhar, there has been mentioned Mandagni Naam Sneha Pito Mandagnu. If have any person who has taken Sneha Pan and ultimately he is not abiding the rules, the Pathya and Apathya, in which there will be formation of arm and ultimately there will be formation of Jalodhar. But nowadays this situation is quite more, less seen. The second scenario that we are seeing, Pran, Agni, Apan, Sandushi, Janyanti, Udranam Naam, these are the pathological hallmarks or pathological hallmarks in Paratantra Jalodhar. If you see Pran, you see the root or the mool of Pran is Hriday and Mahasrut. Okay, so any sort of, and Hriday and Rasvahi Dhamnia also has been mentioned. So any diseases in which there is ascites or there is distension of abdomen because of fluid, that situation will be labeled as ascites due to cardiac cause. As we are witnessing nowadays, many of the cases of the congestive cardiac failure, cardiomyopathy, landing down to the congestive cardiac failure, may land down into ascites. Reason being, there will be a congestion, congestive hepatomegaly. Later on, there will be accumulation of fluid in the peritoneal space. The second thing that we'll see, Agni. There is dushti of Agni. As we taken the Dhatvagni Adhishtan or the Pradhan Adhishtan of the Agni is Yakrat. Where the, we see this situation, there is a seat of Pitt. So any derangement that is involving liver, which are leading down to ascites, may be taken up as ascites due to hepatic cause. And the third entity that we are talking Apan, I am talking about Paratantra Jalodhar. Apan means, if you see any sort of pathology in the kidney and jo filtration wala jo part hai, anything, if it is involved, then it will land down to the ascites, as you see in many of the situations like nephritis, nephrotic syndrome, CKDs and all, in an advanced state, where the involvement is basically of kidney. It is the ascites because of the renal pathology. But how is taking place? As you see, if I am talking about the pathogenesis, then I am saying there are certain pathogens, there is sung leading down to srotorod, and srotorod in the swedvaya and ambuvaya srotas, and ultimately there will be accumulation of the fluid. Okay, but what happens? There one important situation also there, which is called sidrodhar, in which there is any sort of piercing injury to the abdomen may land down into peritonitis. Ultimately, sidrodhar is a situation in which there is direct vimarga gaman. Always remember, when we are talking about sroto dushti, there, if there is sung, primarily there will be sung and followed by vimarga gaman. Chidrodhar is a situation in which you are finding vimarga gaman without sung. But how this sung is taking place, being I have an expertise in kaya chikisar, I will talk about the physiological or pathophysiological hallmarks that had been taking place in sung. What is going on? Actually, as I said, first pathological hallmark is Mandagni Naam Visheshata. Second, it has been mentioned that all the udar roga are tridoshaj. Sarvam udaram tridosh sanghatam matam tasmat tridosham nikriya sarvatra kariya. If you know the pathological hallmarks, then only you can understand the samprapti vector of the disease. Same is happening, there is sung because of the derangement of Agni, and if Agni is deranged, if Agni is not functioning properly, then you jatra anal dorvalyat vipakvastu yarasa sade sange ko amu sarvadosh pakopaka. There will be formation of arm, and ultimately when this arm amen is samprakta samen ityupadishyate, if it is it will adhere with certain dosh and all, then only it can obstruct the channels. As you know the properties, physiological properties of udar, it cannot stagnate anywhere because it doesn't have any sort of property which can stagnate udak in a particular place. But how is taking place? It is taking place because of the saam kaf, and that saam kaf has a property which is called pachilyata. What is pachilyata? It is a tendency to adhere in the srotas, and ultimately because of which it is adhering in the udak channels and ultimately obstructing the pathway. And because of this, there is vimarga gaman and there will be accumulation of the fluid in the peritoneal space, which is called jalodhar. Okay, so same situation that is taking place in the samprapti. So first pathological hallmarks is Agni, second sangapurvak vimarga gaman, third we are talking about the basically what I have said, it is tridoshaj rog. So these are the basic pathological hallmarks. Now if I am talking about Jalodhar specifically, which is a variant of Udar Rog, as we all know there are 8 variants of the Udar Rog, and it has been mentioned by Shushrut that all the Udar Rog, if not treated in a proper frame of time, then they will land down into Jalodhar. You all know that. So Jalodhar is an advanced state. It can be because of these factors that I have talked to you, and because of the complications of the other variants, Jalodhar may land down. If you see, there is accumulation of the fluid in Jalodhar, excessive fluid, and if you see what is ascites, it is excessive and abnormal collection of the fluid in the peritoneal space. Same is happening with this scenario that I am talking about. So now whenever you have any samprapti or any pathological events, then in the line of management you see, you treat accordingly. But always remember, if I'm talking about the Samanya Samprapti of the any disease, then the Samanya Samprapti Siddhant will follow as it is. First, what is happening? First is happening, there is Mandagni Nam Visheshata, there is Mandagni, so you have to go for Agnidipan. There are plenty of the medication available. So Agnidipan is the first and foremost priority in the management principle. Second, what I am talking? Sarvam tridosh udram tridosh sanghatam matam tasmat tridosham ni kriya sarvatra karyat. As you all know, all the udar rogas tridosha, that means seeing the prevalence of the disease or the condition of the patient, you have to plan in certain line of management as per the tridosh shamak chikitsa siddhant. Third one, doso ati matra sanchayat srotomukh nirodhat. What is happening? There is accumulation of excessive doshas in the peritoneal cavity, and ultimately there is sroto avrodh, and that is also landing down the same situation. Doso ati matra sanchaya sroto mukh nirodha tasmat nitya me virechet. Because of these two pathological hallmarks, nitya virechan is advocated in the udar rog. So these principle, in terms if I am talking about jalodar only, these principle will follow as it is the samanya samprapti vigatan of the udar rog. But there are precise what I can say Vishisht Chikitsa Siddhant for the udar rog, as there is excessive fluid there, and fluid is similar to the udar and cough. So what is the line of management of jalodar? Anyone who can guess? Apam dosharna madho pragya dakodare mutra yuktani tikshnani vividam charvanti cha deepani kafaknishchaya tamaher upacharit udakpur nischaya purvakah. इस तरह से उन्होंने बताया. तो आप देखें यहाँ पर जो फ्लूड है वो किसके समानधर्मी है? कफ के. इट इज सिमिलर टू कफ, एंड एज इट इज एक्सेसिव उदक, सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, अपाम दोषणाम आदे. अपाम मीन्स जल, जो जल को निकालने वाली है और उसको जो भी औषधियां हैं दैट यू हैव टू प्रिस्क्राइब टू द पेशेंट. दीपनी कफग्नि एज यू हैव सेड देयर इज मंदाग्नि, इट विल लैंड डाउन, सो we have to go for Agnidipan. Deepni Kafagni. Kafagni Chikitsa, as you know, both the dosh and dusha are similar. Tamaher Upacharet. Deep. So, Mutri Yuktani Tikshnani Vividam Charvanti Cha. Tikshna Ausadhiya. Mutra means especially Gomutra and the drugs we are processed with Gomutra. Seeing all these things, situations, you plan the line of management of the disease, and ultimately, how these are taking place, that you know. There are plenty of medicine available. If I am talking about the precise that I have told you in the Partantra Jalodhar, if I am seeing a case in which there is ascites because of cardiac or reason, as I know I have told you it is because of the prana, in those scenario Hridayanavaras is an ideal choice to be used. Punarnavashtakvath is an excellent drug to be used, okay, along with Prabhakarvati, Nagarjuna Abhra and all. So if you are seeing any case in which there is ascites because of cardiac origin, then you can use these medicines. Similarly, in another situation, if there is hepatic cause, then you have Yakrit Klihari law, okay, and you have Arogya Vardhani, you have Punarnavashtak, Phalatrikadi, these sort of medication that will do. Disease is same, but the presentation is quite much different and the root cause is somewhere else, then you have to go regarding like this. Again, one important thing, the third one in which Apan, and we are talking about the renal pathologies, Chandra Prabhavati, okay, Punarnavashtakva, Shilajit, Gomutra, Punarnava Mandu, these are the drug to be used in those situations in which there is ascites because of the renal impairment. So, summing up all the things, as you all seen, Udar Rog, as an initially it has been said, it has not a very excellent prognosis. Seeing the status of the patient, seeing the condition of the patient and the pathological hallmarks and etiological thing, you may plan the line of management of the disease accordingly. And how the Samprapti Vigatan is taking place, you can see whatsoever I have told you that you have to proceed any cases coming with Udar Rog. So it can be like this. If you have any query, then you can ask. Thank you.